ever wondered if the money in your bank account is secure? The Jamaica Deposit Insurance Corporation, JDIC, offers protection or coverage against your money through deposit-taking institutions that are regulated and supervised by the Bank of Jamaica through five account ownership categories: individual, joint, trust, business, and nominee accounts. Welcome to Finance Matters. I'm Daniel Pasley. And today I'll be speaking with Ms. Peta-Gaye Coombs, Public Relations Officer of the Jamaica Deposit Insurance Corporation, about the deposit insurance coverage that you have access to by just having a bank account. Remember to like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Follow the Ministry of Finance on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter to see all the episodes and highlights. Thank you, Ms. Coombs, for coming on the program.
Thank you for having me, Daniel.
Now, what is the role of the Jamaica Deposit Insurance Corporation?
Well, Daniel, the Jamaica Deposit Insurance Corporation, JDIC for short, was established in 1998 following the financial crisis of the mid-1990s. Now, the purpose of the corporation is to provide what is called deposit insurance. And what deposit insurance does is ensure that any monies that you have in deposit accounts in commercial banks, mm-hmm. billing societies, and merchant banks, you are guaranteed to get those monies back. However, up to a maximum of $1.2
million
financial institution should crash or fail. Another key role of the JDIC is to manage what is called the Deposit Insurance Fund. And essentially, what the Deposit Insurance Fund is, the vehicle which the corporation keeps the premiums that are paid by the member institutions of the deposit insurance scheme, so that you will be able to get your money back if anything happens to your financial institution.
And when we speak about the member institutions, who are we talking about, really?
Okay, so member institutions of the deposit insurance schemes are essentially financial institutions that are licensed and regulated by the Bank of Jamaica and hence mandated to become members of the deposit insurance scheme. And these are commercial banks, and that is every single commercial bank that is licensed for operation in Jamaica, as well as billing societies and the single merchant bank that we have still in existence, making that a total of 11 member institutions of the deposit insurance scheme.
Now, what was the rationale for increasing the limit to $1.2 million?
Okay, that's an excellent question, Daniel. So in August of last year, the JDIC increased the deposit insurance limit twofold, from $600,000 to $1.2 million. And that last increase was implemented in 2006. Now, another role of the corporation is to monitor what is called the credibility of the coverage limit. Because as you're aware, from time to time, things change in the financial sector, as well as the economy, and of course, overseas. So the corporation has to monitor all these variables to ensure that the coverage limit remains credible and that the value of the monies that depositors have in their accounts is maintained. So we keep track of things such as the foreign exchange mm-hmm. rate, the inflation rate, to ensure that the value of your money is maintained. And that is what we do when we say we protect and guarantee your deposits.
So basically, the JDIC is following international standards then?
Certainly. And these international standards are set by the International Deposit Insurance Body that is called IADI, which is the International Deposit Insurance Association. And the JDIC is also a founding member of that association.
How can we find out some more information about JDIC?
Well, Daniel, the JDIC keeps up with the times, and you can definitely keep up with us and the information that we're putting out so that every single Jamaican can understand what the JDIC does and how deposit insurance benefits you by following us on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter at JDIC Jam, that's JDIC JAM, and of course on YouTube at Jamaica Deposit.
Thank you, Ms. Coombs, for sharing some pertinent information about the services of the Jamaica Deposit Insurance Corporation.
Thank you, Daniel.
And thank you for joining us on Finance Matters. Remember to follow us on social media at MOF Jamaica and tune in next week as we continue to demystify the economic and fiscal policies and initiatives implemented by the government to ensure that Jamaicans chart a path to Jamaica's economic prosperity.